know, they were there.
Pakistan has before buying. They can pay money, they can make friends, they can make alliances, pay them off, and they will do the dirty work for them. But that is where they got wrong. Because look, you see, Pakistan has befooled America for 30 years, three decades in a row, 30 saal lagatar. Now 20 years, we were ruled by Afghans. They were Afghans by the Ghani government and the so-called army they tried to build, which literally did not fight. Look at Mazar-e-Sharif. Muhammad Khan and Dostum did not even fire one bullet. They fled to Tajikistan. Who paid them? Obviously China. China knows, Pakistan knows where the money is coming from, that is China. Americans who know that Pakistanis are in bed with anybody to everybody who pays my money. In fact, if I may use a word, today Pakistan is a keep of China. Nothing more than that is what the real status is. So this American way of thinking, we can buy our way through, we can get mercenaries, we can get third party people. That is what the problem is. This is a jihadi Wahhabi mentality which is driven by religion. This is a religion-based extremism. They don't like Americans. When it comes to hate for Pakistan, for America, if you talk to Afghan or Pakistani, the hate is same. They both have the same objectives. But if you give them the money, unfortunately, Pakistan, America has given Pakistan tons of money, and a lot of money was burned in Afghanistan. They took the money. They played along with them for 20 years, 30 years, and at the right point of time, within days, they showed them the true colors. Now somebody has to go and talk to Americans, look, you got it all wrong. Your way of thinking, you can buy your way through in any situation, you can find those, you know, mamus to fight, is not what is going to work. If you have to fight, you have to fight your own wars. That's what I've been saying always. When it comes to India, you cannot depend on any America, you cannot depend on anybody. If we have to survive, we have to learn and we have to fight our own wars, we have to defend our country. And I'm proud, we are General Astana, like people who are at the helm of control, who are at the wheels, and we are Prime Minister Modi who controls the situation. Unless and until you depend on these allies, A, B, C, D, nothing is going to work. We need to remember one thing. I don't want to divert debate, you know, take the debate to a different tangent, but you must have heard about Hindu Kush range. You know what does Hindu Kush in Pashto means? Killing ground of Hindus. Those in those Hindus were massacred. That is what is the perception. That is why that Hindu Kush names comes from. I first thought Hindu Kush is something of pride and to be proud of. But when I looked into the Pashto meaning, it is the slaughter ground of Hindus. This is what the Wahhabi mentality is. This is the Islamic mentality. It's Islamic jihad. Mm-hmm. As simple and as clear as that. Anybody who's non-Islamic is treated
okay,
as an
enemy. Then we need to be even more careful. We have run out
we
of
have
time.
We have to be more careful. Hindu Kush.
We have run out of time. We have run out of time, Sumit Peer. What are we going
to
do?
Money cannot buy people. Money cannot control jihad. The only way to eliminate jihad and jihadis is what you did with ISIS. Bomb the last man standing with the gun. That's the only way to control them. And India should send a message to anybody and everybody. If you dare to look at our soil and to us, you will hear the blast in Kabul with your leadership, with their families, and to the people who are near and dear to you. Unless I tell who said that, Hindu Kush will repeat again and
but
again.
But what, Sumit, we can talk. But Sumit, we can talk like that.
Seconds.
But Sumit, we can talk. One second, Mr. Ocha. At least let me complete what I'm saying. Sumit, we can talk like that. But what happens to our soft power ideology?
Because these jihadis, to them a Christian, a Hindu, or anybody who's a non-Muslim is an equal threat. Even they don't spare their own,
okay,
own Muslims.
All right.
99% of the people killed by them are Muslims.
Okay. All right. You made your point. Let Mr. Ojha come in. Mr. Ojha, I'm going to trust you on the 10-second part.
Yes.